All right, so today we are going to be talking about space heaters. And when I mean talk about space heaters is it's pretty much going to be trying to start fires with them.
All right, so first thing we got is our space heater. Keep away from electrical cords, draperies, and other furnishings. So I'm going to test a piece of fabric. If we can't catch this on fire, then we're gonna move to a piece of paper. And if by some chance that we can't catch this on fire, then we're gonna go to a Kleenex. And by some chance that we can't catch this on fire, I have something very special. Watch the end. Another thing that we're gonna try is we're gonna see, can the heater melt some plastic? And if none of that works, then we're gonna keep trying until we at least catch something on fire.
This is the 3 feet that is recommended. But when you get out here, almost all the heat from the heater has dissipated. So it's not hot at all. It's about when you get about a foot away, when it starts getting uncomfortable. So I'm pretty sure that being 3 feet away, we're not gonna get any type of heat transfer into this. And that's pretty boring. Let's move it closer. So we're going up on 8 minutes. And it's getting hot. Got a feeling I'd be here all day before it even got anywhere near hot enough where I couldn't touch it. I'm gonna give it 10 minutes. Why won't you burn? Catch on fire. Guess we'll move it closer. If that doesn't do it, I don't know what will. All right, so we're a little over 22 minutes into this, and I mean, it's hot. Don't get me wrong. I got a feeling we'd be standing here forever. So what can we catch on fire? I got some paper, but let's try. Here goes nothing. All right, almost 14 minutes. Ah. All right, the paper seems to be getting a lot hotter than the actual fabric was. So I'm gonna go 20 minutes, and then if I'm not getting anything, then we're gonna try something else. All right, so we've had this on for about 20 minutes, and nothing. I mean, the paper, it loses the heat so fast. I mean, from the time I took it off to the time I'm holding it now, I mean, it's back cool to the touch. So the next one I wanna try is the Kleenex. So this is the worst case scenario. You had to get up and get a Kleenex, and you have your space heater on, and somehow your Kleenex gets stuck to the front of your space heater. We have to test everything. Let's see if we can get fire. All right, coming up on 10 minutes. It's hot, but I don't think it's 400 degrees hot. All right, we're over 20 minutes on Kleenex and nothing. Why won't you catch on fire? Here's what I have planned next. Lint from a dryer. But first, let's see. Yeah, I mean, just like the paper. There you have it. So we're gonna reset the stopwatch. See how long it takes. Hopefully it catches on fire. Hate for you to sit through this whole video and not even see fire. All right, so we're about 15 minutes in on the lint. There's still nothing. Doesn't smell any different, like burning. But I wanna know, can we even melt some plastic? So I have this plastic egg carton. I'm gonna put it right up against it and see if we can melt it. Oh, it's melting it.
Look at that. All right, coming up on 20 minutes and no fire. As far as the lit, no fire. What the heck? All right, so we have literally put fabric, paper, Kleenex, dryer lint, 20 minutes directly on the space heater and nothing. We put plastic directly on the space heater. I'm beginning to think that I can't catch anything all on fire with the space heater. So now one more thing I want to try is it also says to keep away from the front side and rear. So I'm wondering if we cover up this back, raise the temperature enough of the element that heats it to actually not ignite and catch draperies, paper, or lit on fire, but actually the whole unit. Let's find out. So here's the plan. I'm gonna take a towel and completely wrap up the space heater and block up every air intake and exhaust port that there is. And the hopes of doing this is to be able to, in a way, insulate and keep all the heat inside of the space heater so that we can overheat the heating element to the point to where it just spontaneously combusts the space heater itself. So let's go ahead and get started. There you go. If this doesn't work, I honestly don't think that we could ever catch this on fire. And then the whole space heater house fires are all a big myth. Why not?
All right, so we moved everything outside because it seems like it'd be a little bit more of an outside activity. So I moved space heater here in the fire pit because I'm having some high hopes that we're gonna see some fire. And for a safety warning, don't try this at home. I was a professional firefighter for 10 years, so I've been through extensive training. So I've taken every safety precaution I can to make sure that nothing does happen. Sit back and enjoy the show.
Turn the water on. Safety first.
Gotta prime your hose.
Whoa.
Hey.
Whoa. Some pressure. Okay.
All right, we're on high. Timer started. So go ahead and comment below on the time that you think it's actually going to take when it catches on fire. Or if you think it won't catch on fire, let me know. But let's find out. Alright, so turns out there's a safety mechanism that shuts it off when it gets too hot. Let's try something else.
Alright, so here's the deal. They put a bunch of safety thermistors in here to where if it gets too hot, it just shuts off. So, for the sake of science, we need to get rid of those. So, thermistor, gone. This has a little flap on it. So this sits right up against the heating element, and once it gets to a certain temperature, this flexes and cuts the contact. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna put a zip tie around here because I don't want to cut and wire everything. I'm gonna put a zip tie around here and zip tie that close so that it will not be able to come apart. And plus I'm gonna leave it here instead of putting it back in against the heating element. Then we'll try it again.
Zip tie. Come on up here.
think two screws will do. Getting all crazy about it. Just gonna burn it to the ground, right?
All right.
Take two.
All right, round two. Every single piece of safety device that the manufacturer put on here has been removed. So, hopefully this works. It only lasted like a minute before it shut off before. So again, put in the comments below if you think it's actually gonna work, and if so, how long do you give it before it gets too hot and catches on fire?
All right, so we're about 4 minutes into it, and I'm already smelling a significant amount of burnt plastic. All right, 5 minute check. The fan keeps getting quieter and quieter, but it's still noisy. Kind of stinks a little bit. All right, so just over 5 minutes, and the fan sounds like it's getting ready to quit. It doesn't sound too good.
All right, we're 15 minutes into it, and the fan just quit, and I don't know if you can see this, but there's a big old gap in the side here. Like all that plastic melted. Looks a little crooked there, doesn't it? Oh. All right, so the fan quit, but I'm pretty sure it melted all the electrical components to the point to where it just doesn't work anymore. So we took a space heater, did everything the manufacturer said not to do, even bypassed every single safety device that they put on it, and we still could not start a fire. But you know what? You came here to see a fire, and I'm gonna give you fire. So there you have it. Every single safety device unhooked, completely suffocated and wrapped in a towel. And the only way I could get it to catch on fire is to put a torch to it for you. Hey, I tried. But the only way that I can get it to start on fire was to use a blowtorch. If you want to see some more crazy experiments like this, hit that subscribe button so you won't miss out. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye!